top secret.
Good morning, Mr. Sue.
Good morning.
Your mission, should you choose to accept it, involves creating the best budget gaming system you can for under $600. In American. So, that's like a bajillion dollars in Canadian, after the exchange rate. Good luck.
Rude. For the GTX 950 launch, NVIDIA invited us to participate in their budget build challenge. And of course, we couldn't say no. So Keys and I put our heads together, did some brainstorming, and came up with the best idea we could. Have Anthony build it while we grabbed lunch. Lunch. Now, we're not sure who else is participating, but we do know that we have to send our system to NVIDIA so they can run it through a gauntlet of tests, including Dota 2, Heroes of the Storm, GTA 5, Witcher 3, 3D Mark Firestrike, and the new DirectX 12 API overhead test. Quite the challenge for a budget build, but nothing our system can't handle. The only caveat was that we had to use a GTX 950 since, you know, this event was all about its release. So, we went with an ASUS Strix 950 since it's a nice and compact card with a very efficient cooler. It's factory overclocked up to 1355 MHz and the temperatures are low enough that the fans rarely even come on during gaming. For the CPU, Anthony went with an Intel i3-4170 and an ASUS Z87-A motherboard. We considered using a 6 or even 8 core AMD processor, but our testing showed that these games and benchmarks rarely use more than 4 threads anyway, so the i3 with hyper-threading was a perfect match. And the Z87 chipset? Well, we didn't really need any of the features Z97 offers, so we saved a few bucks here. Next, we've got 8GB of HyperX Fury memory. It's cheap, super reliable, and looks great. For storage, we went with a Crucial BX 100 128GB SSD. Since Windows 10 only uses around 11GB of storage, it's a perfect match for the set of games we need to run. Finally, everything is powered by an EVGA 500W 80+ bronze power supply and housed in a Fractal Design Core 2300. Notice a trend here? For all you budget gamers out there, make sure to invest in quality parts that suit your immediate needs, but are also capable of easily expanding in the future. We could have gone with a motherboard with only 2 DIMM slots or a 350W power supply, but that's just silly. So with all that in mind, we're confident that we put together a system that's capable of at least 60 frames per second at 1080p with settings that look better than the console equivalent. And if you want to put something together like this yourself, we've included a complete parts list in the description below. Speaking of down below, leave us a comment on what you think of our budget build and whether you'd make any changes to it. As usual, leave us a like if you liked the video and click over here for more videos from us and over here for our Twitters. Well, don't click over here because that's not cool. Stare at it. While you do that, I guess we should start packing up the system for NVIDIA. It's got a long road ahead.
The road is long.
I miss you.
With a many winding tongue.
No! Don't take it away from me.
It's mine.
My precious.